Fruitball is amazing. That's edible. It's edible. Did you make it?
No.
No.
A Tibetan made it.
A Tibetan made it.
Yes.
Well, I was wondering. Okay. Beautiful. Okay. I have to photograph the stupa.
We have a couple more. Lisa wants to send me the pictures.
Very nice. Look at that.
Shambhala.
We should have the photo.
Yes, all the blazing. Okay. It's like being in Bhutan or something. You're wandering around and there's a beautiful white stupa in the woods.
There's only one.
Right?
We need two ages.
No, no, we'll have to.
It's also Nina's birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Nina. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Let's have so many nice friends. Thank you all.
Thank you. And may the whole world soon become Shambhala. And may Minla reign in good health and happiness with all the new generations. Green and beautiful garden earth for everyone, without exception. Okay?
I just want to say there is something really interesting happening. Earth days are very good for your health.
Oh, good.
And scientists have found out people that have more birthdays live longer.
Thank you, Lee. Thank you, every single one of you. It's so nice.
I have to make a big wish for God's
sake. I'm making a wish. I'm on Shambhala already here. My dear friend, David Spengler, used to say, against the crazy evangelical types, the rapture people, that if the New Jerusalem is already here for anybody who is kind and loving and friendly and does the right thing, it's already here. Right, it's on. Not waiting for somebody to come and Jesus to stick out his tongue and blow up the world with nuclear weapons. It's already here if people behave. And similarly, that nice Khenpo Rinpoche and various lamas and His Holiness, it's Shambhala. We don't live on prophecies. Shambhala is already here for anybody who wants to live the love, compassion, and great bliss life. Yeah.